In the last video, we used an integration provided by n8n to access the Open Weather Map API to create our own custom API. It certainly is convenient that n8n provides this node to us. But what happens when we want to access an external API that n8n hasn't created an integration for? Let's find out in this video. But first, a little bit about me and why it may be worth watching this video. I started automating systems for the Canadian federal government. I saved staff so much time and money that I quickly became the go-to guy to automate solutions across multiple departments. I now show others how to do the same for the businesses they serve, and I also run an AI automation agency called Smarter Chats. In case you haven't been following along, we created a workflow that uses a webhook to query the current weather for a given city, and based on the results, we output a custom weather message back to the user. If you haven't seen that video yet, you can check it out up here. In almost all cases, we can use the generic HTTP request node to query an API and get back results. So to demonstrate, here's how we can completely replace the Open Weather Map node with the HTTP request node to get the same results and still have this workflow run seamlessly. Let's unlink the Open Weather Map node by clicking the trash button icon here and here. And we'll move the Open Weather Map node out of the way. We can even disable the Open Weather Map node by clicking this power button icon here. And then you can see that it's deactivated. Then let's click this plus icon here and search for HTTP request node, which is right here, and we'll select it. And that adds the HTTP request node to our workflow and opens it up for us by default. This node will take the place of the Open Weather Map node that we put aside. Now, if we open up the Open Weather Map API documentation, we can see that we can make a URL request to search for the current weather by city. You can see down here, built-in API request by city name. So if I click on that, it brings us down and shows us several URLs that we can put in to make the request. We're interested in this first URL here. The query parameters in the URL require two things, the API key and the city name. Now there's one more optional parameter we need to add, which is units. And you can see down here, it says units, units of measurement, they're standard, metric, or imperial. And if you don't add this, it just uses standard by default. Now we need to add this in order to keep the values working in our workflow. Because if you recall from the last video, I chose to use metric units. We can test out the link provided to us by Open Weather Map simply by copying and pasting it into our web browser and providing the three query parameters I just mentioned. So if I open a new browser and I paste that link in, you can see that there's the city name and the API key that I need. So I'll put in my API key here. I'm going to add and units equals metric. And I'll just put in a city name. So let's say Toronto. And I press enter. And you can see that there's all this information that's come back. But specifically, we can see that it's pulled information for the city Toronto. And it says that Toronto is 19.72 degrees Celsius. Now let's make it work in our HTTP request node. So I'm going to copy this URL link again. I'll select it and choose copy. And then let's go back to our n8n instance and make sure that the method is set to get. And that's what it is by default. It's also what's required for this Open Weather API. In the documentation, it has to be a GET request. And it's also what any API request using a URL with query parameters typically will require. In the URL section, I'm going to paste the URL that we had just copied. So the API key is there, the units is set to metric, and you can see here that the city here is hard-coded as Toronto. But instead of having all this hard-coded into the URL link, I'm going to add it as query parameters. So what I want to do first is I want to delete everything to the right of the question mark. So the question mark is right here. I'll select everything to the right of it, and I'm going to delete all of that. So this is just the base URL that will query the API. Then I'm going to enable send query parameters here. I turn that on, and I can add any number of parameters I want here. So as you recall, there's three things I want to add, and it says, specify query parameters using the fields below. You can also add it as JSON, but in this case, I'm going to select the default. These can be in any order, but we'll start with the city name first. The name must be represented as Q, and that's as per the Open Weather Map docs. You can see that it says Q equals here. For the value, I'm going to type in the city name, which is Toronto. And later on, we're going to dynamically grab this value from the webhook from the previous input. And then let's add a second parameter. So the second parameter, if you recall, is the API key, which is right here, and it's represented as app ID equals. So I'm going to just copy this app ID, go back to N8N, paste that in, app ID, and I'll grab my API key from Open Weather Map, and I'm going to paste that in. If you don't have an Open Weather Map API key yet, you can register for free at home.openweathermap.org, and you can make 1,000 weather queries per day for free. And then I have to add the third parameter, which is units, and units is metric. So effectively, these query parameters are replacing what was after this question mark in the URL. And N8N is actually building this URL using these parameters, but this is just more of a user-friendly way of viewing it. So let's test this step and see what happens. And there's a message that pops up on the top left here saying, waiting for a trigger node to execute. Close this view to see the workflow canvas. So if I go back to the canvas, it says here, waiting for you to call the test URL. So let's open up the webhook, copy the test URL here, click listen for test event if it's not currently listening. I'll open a new browser and I'll paste this webhook in. And if you recall from a previous video, because I'm using a web processor service through Railway, I have to copy this subdomain first and I have to paste it into the webhook URL in order to make it work. So I'll paste that in and press enter. So this seems to be hanging here. If I go back to N8N, click back to Canvas. It does show that the webhook was triggered, but it stopped there. So let's see what happened. It does show all this information, but the query is empty. So let's listen for the test event one more time. Go back to the webhook. I'm going to type in question mark city. I'll type in Toronto. Go back to N8N. The node executed successfully. We can see that it says city Toronto here. I'll go back to the canvas, and then we can go to this HTTP request node. And we can see the input from the webhook that was triggered. And down here, we have city equals Toronto. Actually, if I click test step here, you can see that it actually pulled the information right here. But this is hard-coded. So we want to get rid of this, and we want to drag this city name over into the value so that the city can be dynamically queried through the webhook. So there we go. It shows us a demo result as Toronto. Let's go back. I'm going to click test workflow. And then I am going to type in another city. So let's say Manila. Press enter. And we can see that the webhook and the HTTP request node were both triggered. There's check marks for both of them. But this set is deactivated. And the reason for that is this somehow, this is not connected. So let's connect this. If you didn't get that, this is actually disconnected from the set. So we actually need to drag this and reconnect it again. And then press the power button here, which will activate this set again. So now it's activated. So let's save this workflow and we'll press test workflow again. So let's go back to this webhook. And I'll try Manila one more time. So it says it's 28.73 degrees Celsius in Manila, Philippines with broken clouds. It's t-shirt weather. And if we go back to N8N, it went through this entire workflow, all the check marks worked, and then it identified that the temperature was over 20 degrees and it used webhook 3 as its response, which is what we want. Now, one thing you may have heard me say a lot is to refer to the API documentation. Much of what makes the HTTP request node work is putting in the correct names and values that the API is looking for. So if you're ever having problems getting a proper response from an API, go back to their documentation and double check that you've entered all the parameters correctly. This workflow functions exactly like it did when we used the Open Weather Map node, even though we replaced it with the generic HTTP request node. So this node can essentially replace virtually all API integrations that N8N provides. Those integrations just help make things a little bit more simple and friendly for someone that's not familiar with querying APIs. So even if n8n doesn't provide a specific integration node for a particular service, we can still access it. Now you are familiar with making API requests. So go on and conquer the API world with the HTTP request node. I hope this helped to build up your n8n skills so you can build some amazing API-driven automations. Please remember to like this video and check out my next video in this tutorial series, where we continue to build on the concepts in n8n, including how to add community-built nodes and custom JavaScript or Python code. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.